welcome to the Bailey Minute. I'm your host, Brookahana Bailey, and today I'm here with a really crazy, wacky outfit on that's all going to be for sale. I think maybe I overstyled this one, but it's kind of funny, and I just couldn't help myself. I even wanted to show you, and I probably have to get you to come in closer, but on this, I want you to see that it says official junk dealer. You'll hear me referring often to my junk stores, or it's not meant to be a put down of these stores because obviously I love them. Something I should probably define and let you guys all know. I'll call them junk stores or thrift stores or haunts or flea finds or all of that stuff. It's just, it all means treasure hunting, which I love. And this is one of the things that I found on one of my treasure huntings, and it just suited me so perfectly. Usually just sits in my room with my jewelry as a reminder. But anyway, the jacket top is really super cute. It's a little small for me, but I've wormed my way into it for this episode. And then this also is super, super, super tight. I can barely breathe. It's amazing I can even speak. So I've worn it even higher than maybe it's meant to be worn, but love the print. Think it's a super sweet little skirt. I know it'll probably sell. I'll be at the Melrose Trading Post here in March and then in April, and you'll be able to find it there, but you gotta get it quick if you want it. You can find me in the Y section at Melrose Trading Post, by the way. Just look for Carney Couture or Brooke Bailey. I've got many names, many, many hats that I do wear. Today, what I also wanted to show you, and I kind of felt like it went with this look, was a bunch of the jewelry I've been collecting for the show that I'm doing in June, which is up in San Luis Obispo at the Madonna Expo Center. It's called Remnants from the Past. This year, they're doing a gypsy caravan theme, and I'm all over it. One of the things that I've found recently is this wonderful little faux turquoise. It's like glass and paste, and it's not sterling, but it's old. It's fabulous. It's really delicate, well made. I love the way the clasp works. It's really safe. You're not going to lose this bracelet. So that's one thing that's going to be. I don't know for sure if I can part with this. I got this one at one of the bigger thrifting stores that everybody knows across the country. They do a lot of good and employ a lot of people. But you rarely find something like this at that particular store because they usually sell that kind of stuff online. So I really feel like I've been blessed, and I got really lucky when I find a find like this. When I find a treasure like this. It's got that sort of cool look. Isn't it weird how when you're out and you're finding certain things that you tend to find multiples of that same thing? I don't know. It's almost like a collective unconscious, or the universe is like sending me this certain things, like, and I'm meant to collect them and put them into an upcoming theme in my booth or a show that I'm doing. The other one, this is just in the last few weeks that I found all these. Is this? This one's a little simpler, cuff style. Really like that one a lot. It's going to be very difficult to part with these. If you look closely at this one, I don't know if you can see it very well, but there's a lot of really cool Native American-like markings on that. And once again, faux turquoise, I believe. I know it's not sterling, and generally, I don't know if I mind. I kind of love the fact that, you know, no mines were hurt. Anyway, a lot of the turquoise mines have been closed. I mean, if you can get turquoise from some of these mines, I've done a little research on it. It's just like, you are never going to be able to find it again, except on some of these old handmade, like, Indian pieces. Okay, this one also, this is something I've had for a while. Probably isn't going to be for sale because I'm going to keep this one. It's kind of been part of my mom and I's collection. She let me use it for a while. We kind of trade things back and forth. This would be called a squash blossom sort of style, but it's got the birds, like, fabulous. Love that piece. And then all my beaded pieces. I just keep collecting these every time I find them. And they're just wonderful. Oops. I can't even, like, separate them all, but there's, like, six here. Wonderful, wonderful pieces. I love to layer them. It's super either, like, kind of native-looking or, like, cowboys and Indians or even gypsy. I mean, these just, like, cross so many borders. I love that. No pun intended. Let's see. One of the things I also got recently last year is a pair of little earrings that have the turquoise chips in them. Little dangly jobs. I haven't even polished them up yet. They're stamped on the back. I think they're alpaca silver, which means not really silver. Made in Mexico, but they will shine up still. I think it's just got like a silver plate kind of a thing going on, or silver filled. Really cute. Little tiny bit of silver. And then I got one of these little Satio rugs. They're like little sampler size. Love them on top of dressers with all your jewelry. And normally I go for richer tones, but I was attracted to this for what it was. It's like a little mini carpet. I think what it was too is I had just read an article, and I've been seeing a lot of this. Pastels are huge this spring, so this is going to go really nicely in my booth, that whole pastel look. And kind of on the same theme, but a little bit different, but we're still looking at some smalls that I found recently. I got these neat barrettes. I got two of them. They're made with leather, brass, and they even have patina on them, like a little bit of that green corrosion, but I like it. Those are fabulous, and those are so hippie cool for the caravan show, gypsy caravan show. And then I'm also keeping an eye out for wonderful ways to display my jewelry. And I really like kind of the hand-carved out bowls. This isn't probably very old, but I like it with like the contrast. I've got a couple of these like carved bone pieces or like pre-band ivory pieces that I'll put into darker pieces. Display wood like this because it'll set them off really nicely. Because the one thing's for sure, you can have a busy looking booth, but you still have to really display it well. And that's obviously my favorite part. So stay tuned for more shows and or episodes where I'll be displaying and showing you how to display your beautiful small pieces. And I will see you next time for the Bailey Minute. Thanks a lot.